Greetings ladies and gentlemen, this is Kostopoulos, and I noticed that there aren't exactly many videos on YouTube showing the performance of the new AMD Radeon 6000 series of graphics cards. It is no wonder, given the sad reality of the world we're living in right now with the extortionate prices of the GPUs and their non-existent stocks. However, through a minor miracle of sorts, I have been lucky enough to snag myself one of these. From the local store to replace my trusty RX 5500 XT. So this video will be about how my experience has been using this new GPU on Linux, with some gameplay examples. Interested? Then stick around. So this is the Sapphire's Nitro Plus version of the 6800 XT, which comes with 3 display ports and a single HDMI output. Would have loved to get the SE model with the USB-C port, but beggars can't be choosers, and I'm really happy that it's even a Sapphire card, as it has been my go-to company for ATI / AMD branded GPUs for as long as I can remember, probably back from the 9800 XT days. This, however, will not be a hardware video review, so you can look up the details regarding this GPU yourself, as the direct link to the Sapphire's page for the GPU will be in the description below. This will also not be a complete benchmarking video on Linux, as I simply do not have that many games installed on my PC right now. And if you're thinking that why I don't simply download more of them, then the answer is quite simple. I moved recently, and I only have over-the-air internet available for me at this point, which is pretty unstable to say the least. Usually I get around 1-5 megabits per second download speeds, which fluctuate between having seizures at around 1 megabits per second and going tad over 6 megabits per second from time to time. Needless to say, downloading a single 50 gigabyte game takes days, if not weeks in some worst case scenarios, as I also have other things running which require the little bandwidth that there is. The situation should improve soon, when fiber optics installation gets finished, but until then, I'm going to be keeping myself to the few titles that I do have installed, and some good old games from, well, and good old games, as they are DRM-free and have offline installs available, which I happen to have backed up for this very occasion. In any case, the overall experience with the 6800 XT on Linux has been great for me using Arch. I did the dummy deed of not having the latest kernel available when I initially installed the GPU, resulting in a black screen. But after booting from the USB stick and upgrading the Arch kernel, it started working just fine. No configuration changes were necessary when migrating from the 5500 XT, and everything just seems to work, including FreeSync. I do have some concerns regarding the drivers, as I have heard from multiple sources that there are major issues with the AMD drivers on Linux when it comes to multi-monitor setups and FreeSync. Alas, currently I do not have any other monitors lying around which I could test this with, so take this with a mountain of salt. Also, GPU encoding is still an ongoing issue for the AMD GPUs on Linux. It simply doesn't work reliably enough to be used for recording gameplay sessions. So as for now, CPU encoding remains your best bet on Linux. But let's look into some gameplay experiences, and start off with a single title that I have on my list which actually has a benchmarking mode available, and Deus Ex Mankind Divided. I have deliberately held myself off from playing this game due to poor performance that I have encountered so far, and have been waiting for the perfect GPU to tackle the requirements of this game. Here are the settings which I use to run the game. Everything is set to its highest quality besides the motion blur and chromatic aberration, because screw those effects. It might be subjective, but I seriously dislike when these two effects are used in games. Feel free to disagree. And it seems that the 6800 XT is perfectly capable of tackling Mankind Divided at 3440x1440 resolution, averaging at 84 FPS with a minimum of 67 and a maximum of 112 FPS. It is probably worth noting also that the version of Proton used throughout this test was 5.13-4. At the regular 2560x1440 16x9 resolution, the average measured FPS was 101 with a minimum of 78 and a maximum of 137. So this game is definitely playable and very enjoyable on both of these resolutions, as the GPU manages to keep the FPS above 60 at all times, which is what matters the most to me personally. Another fun little game which I have been fond of and have in my collection is called Astroneer. It's brilliant little space adventure slash exploration game with a randomly generated content where you can research, build, terraform, or just go around discovering stuff in the wild by yourself or with friends. With friends though, it's miles more fun. It's being updated rather frequently with new content, and if you do need a game to play with your buddies where you don't go around killing enemies but focus on exploration and sandboxing instead, then definitely look it up. Anyways, it runs great. Again, maxed out at 3440x1440 ultra-wide resolution, and it manages to run steadily over 60 FPS. Let's take a look at The Witcher 3 with some mods on now. As you can see, settings are pretty much maxed out on everything, including the hairworks, and the mods that I have installed are about improving some NPC character models and the general textures found in the game world. It is an older game already, but getting to enjoy it like this with buttery smooth gameplay hovering around 90 FPS is just marvelous. And last, but not least, there is Resident Evil 3, the Nemesis remake. It really is not a hard game to run on any kind of modern hardware nowadays. But since I have it installed, let's take a look. The settings are pretty much, again, everything maxed out, and the game runs easily over 100 FPS at 3440x1440 resolution. So, to sum it up, I find it to be a very smooth launch for the Radeon Technologies group at AMD when it comes to Linux. Now, note that I did not get the launch day experience, and Arch itself is on the bleeding edge of package availability, so I lack the insight for Ubuntu, Fedora, PopOS and the likes. But given that it has been, what, 1.5 months since the cards were released? For me, the driver situation with the launch looks miles better than what we got with the RDNA 1 GPUs. Unfortunately though, we cannot say the same about the overall availability and the pricing of the cars. At the time of recording, the cheapest RX 6800 XT, which you could get in Estonia, and by get I mean order and pray that it arrives within a month's time, is the Asus ROG Strix model, going for 837 euros, and my Sapphire Nitro Plus model going for 1000 euros. This is ludicrous when you consider the MSRP for the reference model to be $649, which roughly equates to 530 euros. And if that is not ridiculous enough for you, there is also the 6900 XT, which is supposed to cost $999 or around 817 euros. And the cheapest of that bunch is the Asus TUF Gaming OC, which goes for 1374 euros. The highest of the bunch would be the reference models from Asus and Gigabyte, which you could get for an eye-watering 1,700 euros. It is simply incredible how awful the market situation is right now for the GPUs, and I personally don't even expect it to get any better anytime soon with the next wave of COVID stuff flying about. But we do have vaccines now, so who knows? Maybe by summertime, things get better and the prices will stop dropping. Anyways, let's not dive into these topics any further, as it is simply depressing. But if you have a question about the RX 6800 XT, how well it runs specific games on Linux, does a specific feature work which interests you, or anything in general, let me know in the comments below, and I shall do my best to try to get an answer for you. Thank you for watching, and may you have a great rest of your day. Bye bye.